And first, I want to talk to you guys, the Des Moines DSM Hack folks, because it's been pretty remarkable. So, thumbs up on that. And then my team. I know this wasn't the most beautiful project in the world. You guys like to write code. We talked about it afterwards and how they felt and what they got out of it and everything. Okay, so it can be resume builders. It can just give you different experience in working with teams. For me, it's like building community. Everything I do is building community. And yeah, I get teary. Who cares? So we talked about, you know, the fact that I'm 64 years old and wasn't raised with all of this. And they made it so easy to help figure this out, because we're busy cleaning out maggots from eagles. We're busy picking up hawks that have flown into the skywalk. We're busy picking up warblers that have hit the high-rise architectural building, sorry. We're busy picking up snakes that have been run over on the bike trails, sorry. All these animals that come to us, almost all of them are impacted by all of us. And so the community that we build is important to them. How many of you guys have pets? A lot of you. They have veterinarians, right? They have animal rescue folks. But wildlife really doesn't have any of that. And they don't have anyone to pay for helping them with veterinary expenses or shelter when they need it. So when we're cleaning cages and everything, and I need to be raising money to build our facility, we have millions of dollars to raise to get it to where we needed to have it, I needed something simpler to keep track of all this stuff. So at the end of the year, I'm not completely crazy with trying to pull all this information together to turn into the state and the federal government, or we could be shut down. So even the mundane stuff, you guys, is really important. And I want you all to remember that when you're working with your clients. So thank you all for building community and being here.
OnWithLife serves hundreds of individuals every year that have had a traumatic brain injury, and not only are we serving them, but we're serving their families. And the tool that my team built is now going to be used to teach those families about their loved one's brain injury. And it's now more than our director of therapy drawing a brain on a whiteboard, but he'll be able to show them, what does this mean? They'll be able to show them videos of rehab in action, of showing what this looks like. And your loved one injured their prefrontal cortex. Here's some exercises that you're probably going to see at our facility, and it's bringing this real time and real life to these families and these persons served, and that's huge for us. You know, it's tough to put money into marketing when those funds could be used to buy equipment and to help support our persons served, and so this, to us, is huge. This is something we may never have been able to do, because to justify the funds towards that is really tough when we could buy a piece of equipment. So to be able to give this to our families and our loved ones and our persons served is a huge, huge benefit to us, to our therapists, and to our families. So thank you all so much.
Refugee Alliance of Central Iowa.
Thank you. I have to first say thank you to three groups of people here. First, to the DSM Hack folks here. I would have never ever imagined what I'm getting into, because first when Brian mentioned to me, I was thinking, okay, I couldn't believe it, that, you know, that somebody will just take us and help us and just create a website in 48 hours. Okay. And then one friend of mine said, you know what, just don't believe that, just you want to go there, they'll take you. You have to apply for it and then you have to get into it. So I applied and I never ever thought that they would ever kind of get us into it, because I thought we have nothing to offer to them. Why will they ever select us? Anyhow, we're getting in there, and to my amazing team of you know, experts here, Billy, I don't want to say your name wrong again. Billy, I kept telling him Tyler. Tyler is here, and Azra, Bailey, Eric, and Sean for helping us out. Like, you know, most importantly, like, you know. with all me, with my crazy ideas, listening to me 1,000 times and telling them, no, this is not going to work. And then, I literally felt that I was doing a big fight on the wall to explain myself. But they got it, they understood it, and I just felt that it was impossible what they did in 48 hours to do, but we have a start. We didn't have anything, and to start off and just have something out there and then go from there is a great experience. And someone so special, I cannot ever thank her enough, because I'm one staff person for the organization. Brianne, I cannot thank you enough for being here with me. Thank you. If you want to come here, I'll really appreciate it. Honestly, feel very blessed and thankful that you guys helped us, and you guys helped so much. Thank you so much.
All right, Rooftop Foundation.
I'm Barry Toflin with the Rooftop Foundation this year. I'm a little disappointed. I told him not to show our before website. we needed help. I'm in technology myself. I'm on the board of directors for Rooftop, but I don't have the time to do what this is, what they did. This is probably 250 hours worth of work that got done in the last 2 days. And not only that, our team, they got ahead. I think it was last night. I was leaving about 11 o'clock, and they stepped in to help out another team until 2 a.m. It's an amazing thing going on here. I think this is the fourth year I've kind of been around this thing, and I see a lot of familiar faces. I assume that means that a lot of you guys are getting something out of it. Is that you're learning something, you're getting something. There's no doubt that the charities are too. I think I saw something, I don't know if it was yesterday on Slack, somebody mentioned, I don't know what's going on in politics, and isn't that amazing? Here we are doing something amazing, If you look at the news media, all they want to do is talk about the darkness and the destruction and everything that's bad in the world and how much everybody hates each other. And here we are. We got these amazing charities. I love Iowa. I love Des Moines. We have all these people doing great things. They're helping out the animals. They're helping out the humans. They're helping out the environment. And they're empathetic. They're doing good things. They're trying to figure out what the needs of the world are. And here they are doing them. And we got other people that are good at technology, they're good at organizing things, they're good at data and making structure and making things more efficient. And here we are, we're putting these two things together. I think it's amazing. And, I would challenge the organizers of this event, let's make it bigger. This thing's sold out. We need a bigger space. If there's anybody who knows bigger space, let's find it. We need to do more events here. I mean, this is absolutely incredible, and hats off to the organizers. This is phenomenal. It just gets better every year, and I can't be more appreciative. And to now be on the receiving end of it, it's overwhelming. Thank you.
Young Wings Resource Center, I also want to thank the organizers. I want to thank all of you for giving up 48 hours of your life to come out and help all of us, because it does make a huge impact. But I do have to say, we had the best team. They're right over there. And I could not believe the speed at which things moved through the weekend, from this brand new thing about story mapping, them trying to figure out how we can do. And I thought, oh, this is great. I understand this. I can help out. And right after that, I think they started speaking Klingon, because I didn't understand a single word for the next 48 hours. But the end product that they came out with helped us take a gift that had been given to the Resource Center and use the efficiency of technology to make it available to the community at large, which I think is a really amazing impact and amazing gift. And not only that, then they said, well, you're missing this piece, this tablet, so we'll go out and we'll fix that too. So now we have a fully functioning library that anybody in our community can use. And I think that it really is the impact, and that's the special thing about this event. So thank you all.
about you guys, but every year I leave this event feeling a lot more humble and a lot more inspired than when I walked in. And I just want to thank everybody once again. And I would like to ask you all, before you leave, to come up here. We're going to take a great big family photo like we always do. And then when we're done, there is some sparkling wine and glasses at each of your stations downstairs to celebrate. So, first things first, photos, come up, and once again, thank you.